Jeju Island, an island off the southern coast of Korea. Recognized for its pristine natural environment and biodiversity, the island was designated as a biosphere reserve in 2002. Halasan Mountain, Songsan Ilchulbong, and the Gomunarum were registered as natural World Heritage Sites in 2007. In 2010, it was designated as a global geopark and it received all three UNESCO honors. Jeju Island is a prominent tourist attraction in Korea that receives some 15 million tourists each year, 1.5 times greater than Hawaii. But 70 years ago, on this beautiful island, an unforgettable tragedy began. August 1945, independence is finally here. It was an emotional day when many people were released from compulsory labor and the compulsory draft. With the support of the province's residents, the Jeju People's Committee was cruising along the coast in cooperation with the U.S. military government. But the joy of liberation was short-lived. The U.S. military government reassigned government officials and police officers that worked for agencies under Japanese colonialism. The pro-Japanese government officials and police officers were once again in charge and stirred up the province's residents. Then, 2 years later, the commemorative Independence Movement Day rally in the spring of 1947. 30,000 people gathered at Book Elementary School to encourage the creation of an independent nation without the help of the U.S. military. And then there was the shooting incident. A child was killed after being struck by a horse ridden by a mounted police officer. The police fired into the crowd of protesting residents, killing six. The Independence Movement Day shooting incident led to the Jeju Uprising. The shooting by the police set off a large-scale general strike. 95% of students, civil servants, employed persons, and others took part. But instead of grasping the situation, the U.S. military government saw this as communist activity on the island and began all-out efforts towards suppression. In the end, there were three incidents of individuals, including a middle school student, being tortured to death. In the end, it ignited more protests. The following spring, April 3, 1948, the Jeju Workers' Party of Korea opposed elections in the South, which would not entail a unified government. The party was unsupported and incited an armed uprising and collided with the police and U.S. military government. This resulted in massive bloodshed. Peace negotiations were conducted to end the insurrection. But the Orari arson incident that was caused by the police and a right-wing youth group to hinder the peace negotiations was the flashpoint that turned Jeju Island into a sea of fire. On Jeju, only the elections that were held in the South were nullified. In October 1948, drastic measures were taken to suppress the uprising, a so-called scorched earth policy. The middle mountainous areas 5 kilometers from the coast were construed as partisan, and people and livestock were mercilessly massacred. Those fortunate enough to have escaped the massacre died in custody when the Korean War broke out. By 1954, 10% of the overall population of Jeju Island, or some 30,000 people, died at the hands of the guerrillas, the military, and the police. Even after the Korean War, Jeju Island was branded a communist island. The social mood made talk of the Jeju Uprising taboo and caused surviving family members to cease speaking about it. Stricken by the yoke of time and collective punishment, choice and freedom were disregarded, and even the soul could not be free. The Jeju Uprising was presented in the 1957 novel by Kim Sok-pom, titled The Death of the Crow. And the cruelty during that time was also openly exposed in the 1978 novel by Hyun Ki-young, titled Uncle Suni. The 1980s was when democratization and truth-seeking began. The first public memorial was held, thanks to reports by the local press of the Jeju Uprising and civil society activist organizations. The 1990s consisted of a special committee of the local National Assembly, and a pan-national committee to uncover the truth was also formed. Eventually by 2000, the Special Act on Discovering the Truth of the Jeju 4-3 Incident and the Restoration of the Honor of Victims passed in the National Assembly.
Jeju 4-3 사건 진상 규명 및 희생자 내 회복에 관한 특별 법안 대안은 가결되었음을 선포합니다.
After the government conducted a full-scale investigation, the president made an official apology for the incidents surrounding the Jeju uprising.
과거 국가 권력의 잘못에 대해 유족과 제주도민 여러분에게 진심으로 사과와 위로의 말씀을 드립니다.
After the president's official apology, the president attended the Jeju Uprising Memorial Service. Once the project to uncover the remains of Jeju Uprising victims began, the resentment and darkness of the truth finally came to light. 2014, National Memorial Day designated in memory of the Jeju Uprising victims. January 2019, a Jeju Uprising surviving convict is retried and the charges are dismissed. The moments of sacrifice, tears, regret, and emotion have filled the time since the Jeju Uprising.
저는 오늘 여러분께 제주의 봄을 알리고 싶습니다. 4.3의 진실을 기억하고 드러내는 일이 민주주의와 평화, 인권의 길을 열어가는 과정임을 알게 되었습니다. 제주도민과 함께 오래도록 4.3의 아픔을 기억하고 알려준 분들이 있었기에 4.3은 깨어났습니다.